हेलो गाइस, हाउ आर यू? वेलकम टू द फाइनल एपिसोड ऑफ आवर फिलोसॉफिकल सीरीज भगवद गीता. नाउ ओवर द लास्ट 8 months वी हैव कवर्ड 17 चैप्टर्स ऑफ द भगवद गीता एंड आई थिंक आई हैव डन इट टू द बेस्ट ऑफ माय एबिलिटी टू कवर एवरी लिटिल डिटेल दैट दिस बुक हैज टू ऑफर. Now, in some cases, we have clubbed a few verses together, and in some cases where we felt that each verse has its own identity, we have told those verses separately in the form of a video. Now, when we come to the final stage of this book, Bhagavad Gita, the 18th chapter, which is titled as the conclusion of Bhagavad Gita, is nothing but the entire summary of the previous 17 chapters. Now, from start, we saw about human emotions, then we saw about the soul, then we saw about illusion versus reality, karma yoga, jnana yoga, bhakti yoga, such as path of action, path of devotion, path of knowledge, and how yoga plays a crucial role and the difference between the conscious mind and the subconscious mind, and how we need to ascend time and space and go beyond it. Now, through all this, I would have given a lot of examples with the phrase of Kalki Avatar. And also, I would have given a lot of examples on religion, and more importantly, a lot of examples on God. Now, what is God and religion, and how is it related with the 18th chapter? Now, the whole Bhagavad Gita has one simple message that Krishna says right in the very first chapter, and every chapter that follows that particular ideation that Krishna says in the first chapter. Now, there are two types of people in this world as per the Bhagavad Gita: those that are attached and those that are detached. Now, when we take a look at attached, these are the kind of people that in this world we call as passionate, fiery, people with a goal, people with an ambition, people with an aim. And when you have an ambition or a passion, you feel more charged up, you feel energetic, you feel enthusiastic, you feel powerful, confident onto doing one particular task. But in reality, as per philosophy and psychology, your attachment, as much as it makes you strong, makes you weak. And there is a reason why Krishna in the Bhagavad Gita says this throughout the 18 chapters. Because when you're attached to something, you're dependent on time for your attachment to be fulfilled. Now, if you want to have a particular goal to be fulfilled, it is not going to happen today or tomorrow. It is going to have a certain time period for that goal to be achieved. And thereby, that time that is required by you, you become a slave to time. And that is why Krishna says that when you perform an action with the pretext of attachment, then you're always giving rise to a reaction in another time. Now, for 1 second, if you could pause this video and think about your own life, we would all have one thing in common. The things that happen in our life would have a pattern. Like a sequence, like something is already scripted or predetermined. Like without us knowing, we attract the same kind of people. Now we wonder why we have so many characters that resemble our father, so many characters that resemble our mother, so many characters that resemble our best friend. All these things are because we attract the same kind of people in our life, because those are the people that we are attached to over the course of our life. Now, this attachment makes you weak because you are deprived of what you really think in your own mind, and thereby Krishna asks you to follow the second path, which is detachment. And he gives this in the pretext in the very first chapter from verses 22 to 47, where when Arjuna says that if I kill all these people, won't I be the most sinned person on this planet? To which Krishna says that if you are performing this action with the view of gaining a benefit for you or for doing it for yourself, then you would be the most sinned person on the planet. However, if you're performing this action solely for the survival of you as a human being, then you won't be sinned at all. Krishna doesn't ask Arjuna to fight for the kingdom. Krishna doesn't ask Arjuna to fight for the welfare of the people or for even his own family. He asks to fight for his own survival and the rest of the Pandavas and that entire army for their own survival. Now the rule as per the Bhagavad Gita is only one. And if you do everything in your power that maintains your physical body and you let your physical body die naturally, then that as per the Bhagavad Gita is completely natural. However, if you are fighting for something that is not your survival, then thereby you're going away from the natural path and you're creating something artificial. The things that we say as food, water, shelter, clothing and livelihood that we call generally, these are the things that we need in life as per Krishna, where we can perform with complete detachment and going towards the exact path of life. Now, by detachment, Krishna doesn't ask you to travel through space or time, but go beyond it. And that is why the Bhagavad Gita says that by practicing detachment, you don't become one of the devotees of Krishna, but you become Krishna himself. And that is the only difference between a mortal and an immortal. Because the role of a god is not to take care of other people, but to control one's own life. And the nature of life itself is in the hands of karma, as we have seen in countless episodes of Bhagavad Gita. But the nature of controlling one's own life, that is in each of our hands through our practice of attachment or detachment. And only if we practice detachment will we have the ability to even know about ourselves. How many of us feel that only when we are alone do we know ourselves a little better than when we are in a crowded room with a lot of people talking about a lot of things? Similarly, when you have inward detachment, you reach a land of emptiness, completely nothing, where you can think freely, think straight. You're not bothered about an external object or an external person or anything, where your focus is just to know about yourself. And that person, as per the Bhagavad Gita, is God. He is divine or she is divine, because there is no difference between that and that of a Krishna or a Buddha or any other immortal that we spoke about in ancient periods. And throughout the series, Krishna has also said that he is not God. He is just a wise man who happens to have practiced this art of detachment. And as a person, he has traveled beyond time and space because he wasn't attached to anything that involves a time gap or that of a space gap. So this in entirety is the conclusion of Bhagavad Gita. This detachment and attachment can be, in other words, known as illusion and reality. It can be known as conscious and subconscious. So all these things are different ways of saying the same thing on what you really need and what you really want. Now, what you want is a desire. What you need is a necessity. The Bhagavad Gita is urging you to define that crystal clear in every moment of your day. So that, all in all, is the wrap of our video series of covering Bhagavad Gita and decoding all 700 verses in this 18-chapter journey. So that's the wrap of our final episode. And I hope I would have done some justice to this book by giving you suitable analogies and examples and theories. So I thank you all for your support in traveling with me through this journey of around 120 episodes. I learned a lot by doing this series. I hope a few of you would have learned the same and enjoyed the ride. And as far as YouTube goes, I don't know what I'm going to do next or if I'm going to do anything next. But whatever it is, I will keep you posted. But once again, I really mean it. Thank you for supporting me and thank you for watching the channel. And cheers.